Once, I wrote the history of Tsushima. Now, I write of the battle for its survival. Something cruel, something horrible threatens the people of our island. The ghosts of our fallen samurai have returned, called from another world to save us. Mongols landed on our shores. They unleashed a terrible host of Oni upon the land. These demons were a threat to our very souls, and the ghosts of Tsushima rose to fight it. Some say there is only one ghost, but in fact there are many. First, I will tell you of the samurai. They fought for their honor, family, and home. Samurai do not know fear, and bravely meet any challenge. But defense is just as important as an attack. Some attacks cannot be blocked, so warriors learn how to dodge these blows. The ghosts carry many tools of war. Kunai, interrupt a foe. And be defeated with proper training. Ghosts strike the drums to call for the Kami's aid. Samurai are capable of channeling the power of kami through the katana, draining their opponent's life. Skilled samurai master the ultimate expression of explosive force. Ghosts are not idle in their victories, but purposeful in the expression of their achievements. Samurai fight for honor, legacy, and their noble lords. The history books are filled with the heroic feats of these courageous warriors. Hunters are one with the bow. They slay Oni from across the battlefield with a single well-placed arrow. Some say the ghosts possess abilities far beyond our own. They are able to focus their senses and detect an enemy's presence from afar. When they control the high ground, hunters rain death on all their foes. Ghosts claim valuable resources from the dead. It is said the ghosts can scale sheer cliffs with inhuman speed. In these times of war, stories of the ghosts inspire villagers, warriors, and lords across Tsushima. Some have begun leaving gifts as tribute. A hunter delivers varying attacks with their arrows. Some arrows pierce the thickest armor, while others contain the spirit of the fire kami. Hunters create arrowheads made of lightning to stun their foes.
A bow can't be beat!
Hunters create arrowheads made of lightning to stun their foes.
Never saw it coming.
They focus their aim, so multiple arrows fired at once still hit their mark. While the hunters strike from a distance, assassins creep close to kill their victims without a sound. Assassins are shadows in the night. They abandoned the samurai code for the art of stealth and deception. Assassins stalk unseen through the grass, hidden from their enemies until they strike. A skilled assassin can end lives like a whisper in the night. The ghosts often take to rooftops and avoid the gaze of watchful guards. They fly quietly from roof to roof, as if carried by light winds. Glide across ropes and rigging with effortless grace, all to line up the perfect kill and visit death upon their victim. Assassins can vanish into the air, becoming invisible spirits, able to inflict the ultimate surprise attack. Disappear. Assassin's greatest skill is to become an unstoppable force of death, moving like lightning between foes. Assassins are both respected and feared for creating a new art of war based on stealth and adaptability. One final ghost fills our stories with heroic deeds. The Ronin fought for the people and the spirits of Tsushima. These warriors heal their allies, and some say, can even raise the dead. All ghosts work as a team to develop the ideal plan of attack.
Let's go!
Follow me!
When their ghost falls in battle, their allies never leave them behind.
Thanks.
Ghosts mark important locations for their allies to find. The ghosts can summon the spirits of Kami to aid them in battle.
We're stronger together.
Masterless, but they do not fight alone. In times of great need, Ronin heals. Ghosts fight side by side against the evil that threatens our home. Awakened by Mongol hordes who ravage our sea and shore, Oni slaughter whole villages. Demons descend from the mountains, and haunted spirits rise from ancient graves. Tsushima needs these heroes now more than ever. Listen closely to their stories, and help me discover what is unwritten. Help me uncover the legends of Tsushima. Relax for a moment. Listen to these tales. Excellent choice. This is a tale of blood and sadness when vicious Mongols hunted every twin on Tsushima and captured their spirits. The island prayed for warriors to save the twins, and the ghosts answered the call. They tracked the captive twins to a Mongol roadblock. The ghosts tracked the prisoner's trail through the camp, but the captive twins were nowhere to be found. Cart tracks cut deep in the ground provided the only sign of where they went. The ghosts followed the trail. Oh! Ghosts tracked the prisoner's trail through the camp, but the captive twins were nowhere to be found. Cart tracks, cut deep in the ground, provided the only sign of where they went. The ghosts followed the trail. Mongol's eyes burned with dark flame, a sign of their dreadful bond. The cursed Mongols fell, their link shattered. Traveled up the road, escorted by foes protecting mysterious cargo.
Nasıl bu soktur?
With their enemies slain, the ghosts were free to search the cart. Inside, they made a grisly discovery. Human hearts, freshly harvested from the twins of Tsushima. They struck out, following the cart's direction. By reaping the hearts of Tsushima's twins, the Oni were able to tether themselves to each other, sharing a life force that could not be broken so long as one of them remained alive. The ghosts arrived at a war camp to confront its gruesome leaders.
Ah!
Oni fell, vanquished by the ghosts. They would no longer prey on the twins of Tsushima. But a greater threat still lurked in the shadows. Only a powerful Onibaba could have tethered such spirits. But that is another story for another time. I have many legends for you to enjoy. Excellent choice. This is the tale of Io, an Onibaba who gave birth to an inhuman army, imbuing them with an unnatural strength and a wicked hate that rivaled her own. The ghosts set out to stop Io before her army became invincible.
Legium Harsinta, huh?
The soldiers were empowered by Io's rage, her vengeful spirit. As long as she remained, they could not fall. Hit their mark. But Io lived on, for they had only killed a servant.
The goats! Bring them to me!
She's inside me. Feeding. Please. You must stop the Onibaba. She's entered the sacred forest.
Through ritual sacrifice and bloodshed, harnessing pain, anguish. The disciples of Io were able to power her army. As long as the disciples remained...
Tsushima is part of me now. Ever since that day, sacrifices. Humans always have to sacrifice. You only destroy yourself, not me. Tsushima is part of me now. Ever since that day, sacrifices. Humans always have to sacrifice. Now, ever since that day, sacrifices. Humans always have to sacrifice. Tsushima is part of me now. Ever since that day, sacrifices.
Humans always have to sacrifice. Tsushima is part of me now. Ever since that day, sacrifices. Humans always have to sacrifice.
It's not. You only destroy disciples, not me.
The ghosts knew their only hope of stopping Io was to save the other monks before she could consume their spirit.
I was a woman once, long ago, but that was before that day, that horrible day.
As the ghosts drew near to a mysterious village, they discovered a terrible sight. Honorable spirits held prisoner, used as stores from which Io fed.
Nothing but a husk.
Unless her army was defeated.
Oh.
Does one drop in a pond make a difference?
Although the ghosts freed the body, the spirit was no longer there. The disciples dispersed, the prisoners freed, this army defeated. Io grew eerily silent, but had she been defeated, or had she simply moved on to somewhere else? Relax for a moment. Listen to these tales.
Thank you.